It's impossible to not have dreams. See, that's not how dreams work. Let me tell you something about dreams. I believe that you were born with dreams that are preset inside of you, and that those dreams are deeply personal to you, that your dreams are your birthright, and that part of the adventure that life is really, it's like a giant scavenger hunt that's been created for you, where life is giving you all kinds of clues that help you feel the pull of your dreams. And so I'm gonna unpack this for you, okay? Because your dreams haven't gone anywhere. You may not, quote, know what your dreams are, but they are inside of you. They are in the back of your mind. You are just so blocked right now that you cannot feel the pull of your dreams trying to draw you toward them, but it's still happening. So I'm going to teach you something today that is going to change your life, because you don't have a choice about this. Those dreams, they're for you. They were been in there since you were born. They're meant for you. They're personal to you. And I can explain this piece about why they're personal to you. So I have a dream of creating like a weekend-long transformational event where literally we fill a stadium, and the energy and the teaching and the things that happen during this weekend retreat, that they are transformational for 10,000 people. That's my dream, okay? When I share that dream with my dad would rather stick a needle in his eye than think about standing on a stage in front of 10,000 people at an event he created. Because that dream is not meant for him. That dream is personal for me. And so when I see other people out there creating events and filling stadiums, I feel deeply jealous, because there's something about what somebody else is doing that reminds me of this dream that I have, this dream that I maybe feel a little blocked on, this dream that maybe I gave up on. Now let me talk about my dad. My dad casually mentioned a couple years ago that he had always dreamt of hiking the Appalachian Trail from one end to the other. That takes like 6 to 8 months. I can't think of anything worse than hiking the Appalachian Trail from end to end with wet socks and wet underwear and pasty teeth and sleeping in a lean-to and eating out of a can and a can. This sounds like a nightmare. Why? That's not my dream. It's not meant for me. And so your dreams, I'm telling you, they're still in there, whether you can feel them or not. So that's number one. You got to accept the fact that you were born with dreams that are meant for you, and your job is to get unblocked so that you can feel the pull. The fastest way to get unblocked is to follow your jealousy. Now, that may sound like the most screwed up advice from somebody that is trying to help you improve your life, but trust me, jealousy is a super important signal. Because jealousy is just blocked inspiration. That's all that it is. You see, you've convinced yourself that your dream is impossible for you. You've convinced yourself you're not worthy of it. You've convinced yourself you're too old, or you're too young, or you're too this, or you're too that, or you're not good enough or smart enough or whatever the hell it is. You've convinced yourself that your dream that was meant for you, that you were born with, that's personal to you, that it's not possible. But you still feel jealous of other people. That tells me that your dream is in the back of your mind and jealousy is your inspiration, only it's blocked by your self-doubt. And so look around and see, who are you jealous of and why? Because there's something in that negative feeling that's an important signal for you. That jealousy is trying to wake you up and make you pay attention, that there's something that somebody else is doing. It could be the relationships that they have. It could be their health. It could be the discipline they have in their life. It could be what they do for a living. It could be their lifestyle. There's something about what that person is doing that's meant for you. Now, you're going to do it your own way, but your problem right now is that you're blocking yourself from even pursuing it. So, rule number one, your dreams never leave you. So accept that as a fact. They've been in there. You're just blocked. Rule number two, to awaken yourself, look around and notice who you're jealous of, and allow yourself to start to follow that jealousy, be pulled toward it, unpack what you're learning about why you're drawn toward what these other people are doing, and start pursuing it and making it your own. That is how you get unstuck. That is how you start to find your dreams. That is how you let the pull of that blocked inspiration that feels like jealousy pull you toward what is meant for you. Those dreams have not left you. You are blocked, and you can change it.